Pat Summerall here with John Madden, and all that buildup and all of this hoopla, John, is it as big as it seems?
I think it's bigger than it seems. And if you're one of these players or one of these coaches, it's the biggest thing in your life. And it's something that there are 30 teams in the league, and there are 30 teams of players and coaches, and every one of them want to be here today. And then you say, well, how big is that? It's even bigger than that, because it's not just getting here today, but it's winning today. And I think that the biggest difference in sports, or the biggest gap in sports, is the difference between the winner and the loser of the Super Bowl. The winner, you're world champion. They can never take it away from you. You'll never forget it. The loser, they just get thrown back in the pile.
There are two survivors, the Patriots and the Packers. They're going to play finally after all this buildup and all this being caged up, the players and the coaches. Let's talk about the Patriots first. How do they approach this game?
Well, I think that Drew Bledsoe has to have a big day, and he has to get off to a good start. We talked to Bill Parcells, we talked to Drew Bledsoe, and in their game planning, that's the way they start. That they're going to give him plays that he likes, plays that he has confidence in, so that he can get off to a good start. Because if the Patriots are going to win, Drew Bledsoe has to have a big day.
And they believe they can air it out. They can go deep. Somewhat a similar situation for the Packers and Mike Holmgren.
Yeah, but, you know, Brett Favre's a little different. I mean, Brett Favre, I think, has more confidence in Drew Bledsoe. Brett Favre has been the MVP of the National Football League the last 2 years. Brett Favre is capable of getting off to a real slow start and then making up for it later. He says, all I have to do, he's like a nose tackle. He said, all I need is a few good hits or I'm ready to go.
But like every other game we've ever done, it's going to be one in the trenches.
Yeah, I think if the fans at home are looking for anything to say, what are the early indications in this game? It's always right up front. It's a line of scrimmage. Who's winning the battles at the line of scrimmage? Because if you don't win those battles, then it doesn't make any difference what Drew Bledsoe or Brett Favre do.
Coming to midfield for the coin toss ceremony are Patriots captains Chris Slade, Mike Jones, and Bruce Armstrong. Representing the Packers are Mike Winters, Desmond Howard, Leroy Butler, Mike Prime, and Reggie White. The referee for today's game is Jerry Austin.
Back up, back up. Gentlemen, this coin commemorates the 31st Super Bowl. The side with the helmets on it will represent heads. Who's going to call the toss? Please call it while it's in the air. Coach Stram, would you please make the toss?
Heads.
Heads he calls.
Toss back.
It is a head. You have won the toss. Which goal do you wish to defend? Step over here, please. Step over there. You want to kick that way? New England won the toss. They elected to receive. Good luck, man.
For a final remark and thought, Bill Maas of Fox is down with Bill Parcells of the Patriots.
Thanks, Pat. I'm here with Bill Parcells. Coach, you've been in a lot of these games before. What did you tell the guys in the locker room?
I tell them, don't worry about winning the Super Bowl. Just worry about beating the Green Bay.
Let's go over to the Packers sidelines with Ronnie Pitts.
Joining me right now, Green Bay Packer head coach Mike Holmgren. Mike, you've been in this game before as an assistant coach two times. Your first time as a head man. Can you begin to describe what's going through your head right now?
Ronnie, it's quite different. I worried about everything all week. But now, you know, once the game starts, it's between the lines and our guys are ready to go.
Number one key to success for you guys today?
Well, turnovers will be a big part of this game, and really which quarterback I think plays the best today, that team's going to win.
All right, Mike. Good luck, as
Thanks,
always.
Ronnie.
All right. Pat, let's go back up to you and kick this thing off.
All right, Ronnie, thank you very much. Your old adversary, Hank Stram, had a pretty good toss.
Yeah, I know. I didn't think that thing was ever going to stop. Yeah, you know, both coaches are talking about their quarterbacks and how they want to calm them down. And I know Mike Holmgren was saying that maybe the team that wins will be the team that their quarterback calms down first, because you know they're going to be excited. I was talking to Brett Favre before the game, and he was saying, you know, everyone says that I'm nervous, and heck yes, I'm nervous, but how do you not be nervous?
There'd be something wrong with you if you weren't nervous. Back deep for the Patriots will be Dave Meggett and Hassan Graham. Craig Hendrick will kick it off for Green Bay. So Drew Bledsoe will have a chance to calm down first.
I don't think he'll calm down first. I think he'll get excited first.
It's going to be Graham at about the four. And Graham is taken down around the 20. Two-time Pro Bowl selection, Drew Bledsoe. The Packers come with a blitz on first carry. Martin. The ball carrier stopped by Brian Williams. Let's look at that strong Packer defense. Jones, Brown, Dotson, and Reggie White up front. Front four. Williams, Ron Cox in the middle, and Wayne Simmons. Evans, Robinson, Butler, and Newsome, the secondary. It'll be second and 10. Martin stopped for no gain on the first. And Bledsoe back to throw it. There's a man open. It's Jefferson, first down for the New England Patriots.
And that's what they were talking about, is getting Drew Bledsoe comfortable, and there's no better way to start off comfortable than a good completion. Here's Sean Jefferson here. He's going to run up, and then he's going to run in. It's a zone defense, so he just comes under control. Bledsoe hits him perfectly. But again, I talked about the line of scrimmage, and what's making him comfortable is good pass protection.
Martin stopped at the line of scrimmage. No gain again on the first two rushes by the Patriots.
Well, they're really playing that line of scrimmage tough for that sweep. That the first sweep that they ran, the cornerback Greg Newsome, he came on a right. on a blitz, and they're getting their safety up there, Leroy Butler, on first down. So what they're trying to do on first down, the Packers, is take away that strong side sweep of the Patriots.
Second and 10, passing down for Bledsoe. Byers split wide to the left. They run a draw play to Martin. He gets a couple. That's going to bring up third and about eight.
See, I think that's one of the things that they're trying to do, Pat, here is to widen out. You see, you got one, two, three, four wide receivers, and then all you have is a box here. Now,
complete, and the Patriots will have to punt.
I still think that was a pretty good start for the Patriots, though. They got a first down. They got the ball, you know, outside the 35-yard line, so they're going to have pretty good field position. And I think that getting a first down is not a great start, but it's not a bad start.
So Tom Tupa back to punt for New England. They'll try to keep it away from the dangerous Desmond Howard. He has hurt a lot of people with punt returns this year. He kicks straight away. Howard's going to have a chance. And he's got some room. Desmond Howard with a good return up to the 45. Knocked out of bounds there by the punter, Tupa.
You talk about offense and you talk about defense, but it can be special teams that can win big games too.
Special teams and turnovers. A 51-yard punt, a 32-yard return by Desmond Howard. Back at the Superdome in New Orleans, the Packers will take over after a good punt return. In fact, the third longest punt return in Super Bowl history, 32 yards by Desmond Howard. Favre goes quickly. That's Edgar Bennett. He got perhaps a yard, no more than that. Let's look at Favre's Green Bay offense. What a year he had. The most valuable player in the NFL, Brett Favre. In front of him, Wilkerson, Taylor, Frank Winters, Adam Timmerman, and Earl Dotson. Wilkerson, in recent weeks, has been outstanding. Bennett and Henderson, the runners, Antonio Freeman and Andre rising wide. Mark Shimura, the tight end. Bennett, the lone setback. Two tight ends set up for the Packers, and Favre back to throw his first one. Going deep, has a man open. Andre Rison does the dance in, and Favre got settled down in a hurry.
That is a way to settle down. You know, sometimes you have to start with short passes. I always said when you got a strong arm guy and you want to settle him down and he's anxious, just show it, throw a deep one. That's exactly what they did. Here's Andre Rison. He's in the slot. He's going to come up against Otis Smith there. He just makes a good, quick move to the post, just runs right by him. Brett Favre throws a perfect pass. That was maximum pass protection. They had two tight ends in. They kept them both in. They had one guy that they were going to take the shot to. It was going to be Brett Favre to Andre Rison.
54 yards from Favre to Rison. The extra point by Chris Jacke is good, and the Packers draw first blood.
Here's Andre Rison here. He's going to come up. Here's Otis Smith trying to cover. He's going to run a post right here. Watch what they do. They have both tight ends blocking. That kind of brings the safety up. So Otis Smith has no help to the inside. But see now, Andre Rison starts outside right there. He makes a move. Boom, right there. And there's no one in the middle of the field because they kept two tight ends in. They went maximum protection. Brett Favre had time and threw a perfect strike to Andre Rison. And that play was set up as one of the plays that they were going to go to early because that was in the script.
Line drive kickoff by Hendrick is down in the end zone by Dave Megan. Here's the coach, first of all, that gets that touchdown, Mike Holmgren of the Packers.
Not only the coach that gets the touchdown, but he's the coach that called the play that got the touchdown.
On the other side of the field, Bill Parcells. Let's see his reaction.
Well, I know the thing that he was worried about, as he said, I'm worried about them getting a big one. I'm worried about them getting deep on us. And lo and behold, it happens right off the bat to him.
And he also said, if we do get behind, if they do get a big one, we can't be discouraged. Here's Bledsoe back to throw. Pressure under on him. Gets it out to Curtis Martin. He picked up a yard. That's all. As the Packers reacted quickly.
Yeah, Pat, we talked earlier about how one of the things you can look for early is who's controlling the line of scrimmages, and so far the Green Bay Packers are. I mean, you looked at that play on that touchdown, and they had all kinds of protection, and you watch the type of rush they have here. Gilbert Brown is dropping back. That's that zone blitz. And you say, who's covering Curtis Martin? It's 350-pound Gilbert Brown.
You're kind. At 350. Juggling interception by Doug Evans, and the Packers get in good shape.
And the Packers are coming out here and they're going after him. They aren't waiting around to see what's going to happen. I tell you, Doug Evans really got a jump on that one. Watch Doug Evans. He's going to be right here, and it's going to be an out on his side. They bring him in, but see how he starts to cover the out, and then right there he takes the jump. Because at first he was behind the receiver, and then when he jumps a ball, he jumps right in front of the receiver. I tell you, that is confidence. The ball was going to Terry Glenn. Yep. Doug Evans had good coverage on him and then jumped it. Fritz Schirmer, the defensive coordinator, is saying that's the way to jump that out.
First and 10 at the New England 28-yard line. Far back to throw it. Out of the pocket he comes, and down he goes. Back at the 38. He lost 10. Let's look at that New England defense. Things have been happening so fast, we didn't have a chance to do that. In front, Willie McGinnis, Sagapolitelli, Mark Wheeler, and Ferrick Collins. The linebackers, Collins, Johnson, and Slade. And the secondary, Otis Smith, Willie Clay, Lawyer Malloy, and Ty Law.
And of course, Otis Smith, he was a guy that was covering Andre Rison on that touchdown pass, but he had no help at all to the inside, no safety help at all.
Second and 20, draw play. Dorsey Levins gets the carry and gets about 4 yards inside the New England 35-yard line.
Anytime you see number 27 in there, Scooter Magruder, Patriots are in some kind of dime defense. And you see him in there now, they usually have. They have 5, 6, and 7 defensive backs. See, and here they are. See, they have all their defense, but 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. They have 7 defensive backs in on that last one, and they'll probably be in the same type of defense now.
4 wide receivers this time. Favre, screen pass to Levens. This is what killed Carolina a couple of weeks ago. Levens gets inside the 20, about a yard shy of a first down.
You see where Brett Favre ended up? Here he is back there. He was way down on the 35-yard line. He gets back. You know, anytime you throw a screen pass, you want to invite the pass rush, and then you let your guy get out there, and then you keep going deep. And you see Brett Favre, he just kept going and going and going after he threw the ball to Dorsey Levens. Levens has really become quite a threat in this Packer offense in the last month or so.
So Chris Jacke comes on from 37 yards out with Hendrick holding to try to put 10 points on the board for Green Bay. And he does. Green Bay 10, New England nothing. Super Bowl 31 at the New Orleans Superdome. Pat Summerall with John Madden. Craig Hendrick set to kick it off. Dave Meggett back deep with Hassan Graham. They'd like Meggett to handle it. And he will, and bring it out from about 4 yards deep in the end zone. Out to the shy of the 20 just a bit for his efforts.
There we see Bob Kratch, number 61, Pat, going in for the Patriots, and he's going in at left guard for William Robertson. Bill Parcells told us that he was going to put Kratch in some. Kratch, of course, was the starting right guard for the first 4 games, and then hadn't gotten back into the starting lineup because of injury. But he says that he thinks he's going to need Kratch in this game to get some running going, because to get running going, they have to be able to block those 2 tackles, Gilbert Brown and Santana Dotson.
And they hope that they can tire Gilbert Brown out. Pass intended for Byers, deflected. Bledsoe was saying how much he liked this field because it's flat. There's no crown here in the dome.
And watch Santana Dotson here. That's the guy that we just said they put Bob Kratch in to help block on those 2 tackles, and Bob Kratch went in, and the guy that he was blocking was Santana Dotson. Santana Dotson was the guy that knocked the ball down.
There's a guy that's really been a big help to the Packers throughout this year. Santana Dotson. That's Meggett in motion, and here is Bledsoe with a screen pass to Byers. And Keith Byers, midfield, and into Packer territory, tripped up finally by Doug Evans. That's what they needed, a shot like that.
Yeah, when you talk about old timers, guys that have been around, we say Reggie White needs a Super Bowl win. How about Keith Byers? He's here just as a fullback. Now, this is a screen. You invite the rush to come, and then you act like you're blocking. Then you get outside, your line slides down. You get a couple of good blocks there. And Keith Byers is like a 245-pound guy. So when he gets in that open field against those defensive backs, he is tough to bring down.
Pretty nifty, too. Here's Bledsoe to throw it. Drops it outside to Curtis Martin, and Martin slips a couple of tackles and moves inside the Green Bay 30.
Yeah, we talked about confidence in a quarterback getting it. You get it with a couple of completions, but here is the most important thing. Watch this pass protection. Boom, boom, boom. Everyone right there. You see the pocket that Bledsoe and throw the ball. He had time to look downfield. He had no one open, so he came off to Curtis Martin. But on that battle right there, the offensive line of the Patriots won the line of scrimmage fight.
Give Bledsoe time, and he can throw it. So can Favre. Here's Bledsoe back. Rush hard. Incomplete this time. Intended for Martin. I don't know if that was a screen pass or just in a hurry or what that was.
I think it was a type of screen pass. They had run one earlier to the right, and that's what they wanted to do, is run it to Reggie White. This was going to be a screen pass. Yeah, and he was throwing it to the left. He got a blitz by Doug Evans.
And there's a flag on the play. Jerry Austin is the referee. This is his first Super Bowl.
You know, Reggie White just took himself out.
Touching by number 61 of the offense. The penalty for that is loss of down. Second down.
That's Bob Kratch, who came in the game. And, of course, it was a screen. So when you throw the screen, now here's Kratch here. Now he's just out there blocking. It's not his fault. but the ball hit him right in the hip.
Right.
Yeah, I mean, he's just going to block and block. He's just a big old lineman. The screen didn't get out. The screen was to Curtis Martin. He didn't get out. So it hit Cratch in the backside.
Gabe Wilkins has replaced Reggie White. And here's Bledsoe to throw quickly, and it's batted down by Gabe Wilkins, who just came in the game.
Yeah, Reggie's coming back in here. You know that big screen pass that they ran to Keith Byers? That was to run at Reggie. Here's Wilkins right here. Now, he really doesn't rush up the field. He starts up the field, then he just stops because he was getting cut. And instead of going down with a cut, he stopped, pushed the guy down. You see him push him down and then get his hands up. That was Ben Coates trying to block him or cut him. Gabe Wilkins played that well.
Yes, he did. Third and 10. Patriots at the Packer 27. Bledsoe. Incomplete. A flag on the play intended for Jefferson in the end zone, and a penalty flag in the end zone.
That'll put the ball on the 1 yard line if that's pass interference. I'll tell you one thing about these wide receivers of the Patriots, both Terry Glenn and Sean Jefferson, they have great speed. Not good speed, great speed.
And great endurance.
Pass interference, number 21 in the end zone. First and goal from the one.
Called against Craig Newsome, the offender.
And you're going to see it in the end zone. I think he grabs his helmet. You see right there, he's going up. You see he puts his right hand on his helmet and his face mask and right in front of Sean Jefferson's eyes.
First and goal at the one for New England, Bledsoe. Touchdown to Keith Byers. Bill Parcells said yesterday, Keith Byers is going to do some things in this game tomorrow.
Because Keith Byers is the type of guy that can do a lot of things. He's a fullback, he could be a tight end, an H-back, a wide receiver. The big play on that was his screen pass. Watch his fake. They get down here in the goal line. This is what you call a run pass. You see they fake, they have a good run fake in there. No rush, Bledsoe has time, and he finds Keith Byers on the end line.
Vinatieri for the extra point. It's 10-7, Green Bay. Green Bay 10, New England 7, first quarter. A lot of people thought there were going to be a lot of points scored today.
And of course, the one that got it started was that screen pass to Keith Byers. That was for 32 yards. And of course, the pass interference pass to Sean Jefferson.
The one who got it started for Green Bay was Desmond Howard on his first punt return. Let's see if he handles it this time. Indeed, he does at the 5. This time he is cut down from behind at about the 18-yard line. Terry Ray, who is down. Here's the touchdown again.
Yeah, now watch the effect of the play pass. It brings both of these guys in. Here's Keith Byers. He's going to come back here. The closest guy who really gave him trouble is this guy right here. The umpire almost got in the way. But see the play fake? You fake the run. Boom, the linebackers come up. Duck, umpire, duck. He finally did. And there Keith Byers gets it. Now remember the one to Sean Jefferson? Watch what they did to Reggie White. In essence, they really triple teamed him. Rucci had him, Lane had him, they got him on his back. That was the side that they were throwing deep to.
First and 10, Green Bay at the 18. Favre gives to Bennett, and there is nothing there. The Patriots are over with great pursuit. Slade, Johnson.
There's a football player, that Ted Johnson.
Oh boy.
I'm really impressed with him. I mean, he's a guy that is a bright guy, a second year guy, and he just seems to know everything. I mean, you just watch here, he's gonna read, and the minute he sees that thing, he's always working upfield. You see what he did to that blocker? He just exploded on the blocker, knocked him into the running back. But I'm really impressed with this guy. I mean, this guy is going to be one of the best inside linebackers in football.
Three wide receivers and Levin nudges over the right side and picked up a couple. Chris Slade again led the defense.
And that's who they want to run at, is Chris Slade, because Chris Slade
is a good up the field guy. He's a good pass rusher, and I think if he has any weakness, it's being running right at him. That's what the Packers are going to do, but he wasn't weak on that play. There's a guy, Robert Brooks, remember when was injured against the 49ers? And Packers top receiver.
Four wide receivers this time for the Packers. Levens in the backfield. Intercepted by Magruder.
Oh, Scooter Magruder was close on that one, and that's the defense that we talked about that the Patriots use. They call that their dime defense, but they have in essence a seven defensive backs, so they're going to have everyone double. Scooter Magruder was right there playing underneath, got the jump on it, and almost got the interception.
Hendricks kick. It's going to be handled by Meggett at the 44-yard line. Meggett retreats, and there's no place to go as he gets back to about the 42-yard line. 10-7 Green Bay, Super Bowl 31. Keith Byers is somebody that can do a lot of things for you.
Well, on that drive that the Patriots scored the touchdown, Keith Byers had the two plays. This one was a big screen pass, and then they went play pass down in the end zone, and he finds Keith Byers for the touchdown. So two of the big plays on that Patriot drive were Keith Byers plays.
Bledsoe, play pass, drops the throw, has a man wide open. It's Curtis Martin, and he gets to midfield.
That was the old bootleg throwback where they fake to the left, and he bootlegs, Drew Bledsoe bootlegs to the right, and then he throws back to Curtis Martin. Drew Bledsoe's dad was a coach. Now watch him. You get a fake here, you bring Bledsoe over here, and then he's going to throw back across this way. So you fake it to that side, bootleg to the right, and then boom, stop and throw it back to the left to the guy that you originally faked to.
Two tight ends. Martin. A little bit shy of a first down. He needed three. Both of these teams script their first 15 plays.
And both of these teams had their quarterback in mind when they scripted them. You know, and you can see Bledsoe had four runs and 11 passes. Now here's the key, passes under 10 yards. See, of those 11 passes, 10 of them were under 10 yards. So they want to start Drew Bledsoe out with some passes to get that established, but shorter passes.
Third and one. Bledsoe is going for the bunch. Firing deep to Terry Glenn, who's got it at the five. Eugene Robinson.
We said that these wide receivers could run. We saw Sean Jefferson do it. Terry Glenn that time. Drew Bledsoe had so much time that Terry Glenn could start on the left side of the field, have double coverage, go all the way across the field. Look, he's going all the way across the field. That's how much time Drew Bledsoe had to make a perfect throw to Terry Glenn. But again, it all starts at the line of scrimmage, because if Drew Bledsoe didn't have a good fake with a play fake, didn't have this much time for Terry Glenn to do that, then it wouldn't happen.
It also all starts with that call on third and short.
That's Bill Parcells.
It sure is. Here's Bledsoe back to throw. And touchdown New England as they take the lead to Coates.
He got his confidence. I don't know if he had it coming into this game, but I guarantee you right now Drew Bledsoe has confidence. Bill Parcells is pulling it all out. He's going for it. Again here, another bootleg. And you're going to see him fake again to the left, a bootleg out here to the right. And here he finds Ben Coates, gets him against the linebacker. Ron Cox was the guy covering him. Coates working on Cox makes Parcells happy.
Vinatieri for the extra point. Tupa is the holder. And the Patriots lead it 14-10. How quickly things can turn around.
Hey, remember that long pass to Terry Glenn? It all starts with pass protection, but pass protection can be helped by a good fake. Watch this fake that Drew Bledsoe has right here.
He fakes that ball to Martin, then he even bends over and hides the football. And because, but look at the pass protection. Look at the time he has. He had all day to throw it because Terry Glenn, to run that far, even though he is fast, needed all day.
Bledsoe with that 6'5" or 6-inch body just doubled it all over the ball and hid the ball entirely.
You know, and I think that's part of having a dad as a head coach. He said he learned things like play fake and screens before he learned how to use a knife and fork.
That's Ray Perkins down at the far end, who's the offensive coordinator, does the play calling, and that call, remember, was on third and less than a yard.
And again, it was a great play fake by Drew Bledsoe and by Curtis Martin. But again, it was great, great pass protection by that offensive line of the Patriots.
Patriots lead it 14-10 as Desmond Howard is hit at the 25 and taken down there. The Patriots are excited.
I think you can just feel momentum change, can't you? I mean, this thing starts out, and the Packers came out, and they were all fired up. And early in the game, Brett Favre hits a big one to Andre Rison. It looks like they have everything going. And then it comes back, and then the Patriots get this thing back. Again, here's a touchdown. You see the bootleg. He's coming over it. Good pass protection. And then you see he has plenty of time to find Ben Coates in the end zone.
So the Packers take over at their own 25. Regular offensive set. Favre on the play pass. Has a man open. Missed him. It was Rison.
That's an area that they're going to work on. Otis Smith over there on that side, that right corner of the Patriots against Andre Rison. He was wide open. Watch him. Otis Smith is up there, but he doesn't get a bump. You see, he goes to get a bump. Andre Rison gives him a little move and runs right by him.
Whoa.
I tell you, if Brett Favre had just thrown that ball to the inside to Andre Rison, that would have been a touchdown. But that has to give Brett Favre some confidence on Andre Rison to know that they're going to have Otis Smith out there all day.
They better give Otis Smith some help. That's Levin at the 30-yard line. Right now, Ron Pitts has some information. Ron?
Well, Pat, after that last touchdown, when the Green Bay Packers defense got to the sideline, Fritz Schirmer, the defensive coordinator, immediately came over to him and said, hey, just relax, play your game, we're okay. Now, that sounded good, but you know, the Green Bay Packers on defense aren't used to being in this position that early, so let's see how they handle it. Pat?
You are so right.
I think more than relax it, no, I think they got to forget about the run and rush the passer and not go for all those play fakes.
Freeman was the man in motion, and Favre is taken down by the rush from the Patriots.
That's Teddy Bruschi.
Bruschi was there first.
Yeah, what they do is on passing downs, when the Patriots go to a three-man line, they put in Bruschi. And Bruschi is here. Now, he can either be a linebacker and drop out, or he can be a lineman and stay down. They don't know what he's going to do. That time, he just rushes. He just goes right by Timmerman. I mean, he hit Timmerman, boom, and just pushed him right aside and went right by him.
And Slade came from the other side, and Hendrick is back to punt. And the Packers have lost that momentum. This is a good kick, however. As Meggett retreats to the 14. Up the middle of the field, Dave Meggett past the 30 to the 33. 57-yard punt, 20-yard return. Here's Bledsoe, another play pass, fake. And Bledsoe just throws this one away.
We were talking about the things that the Packer defense has to do. Is I think they have to stop going for the play fakes. I think they just have to rush Bledsoe. And then maybe on the way, if the Patriots start to run, then maybe on the way to the rushing the passer, then maybe just run into a run. But I think if they continue to go for play fakes and get caught and stopped on the line of scrimmage like this, and to give Drew Bledsoe all day, he's going to eat him up.
Well, Fritz Schirmer said the first thing we got to do is stop the run. You can't be too concerned about that, though. It's a draw play to Martin. Martin to the 38. Patriots in their own territory. That'll bring up third and about four.
See, what Fritz Schirmer says is he tries to start every game
where he just plays four man and hope that they can control the line of scrimmage and rush the passer. Then if they can't, he'll add a fifth, which is a blitzer. If that doesn't work, he'll add two blitzers, which is six. If that doesn't work, he'll add seven. If that doesn't work, he said he'll go to just a three-man rush and cover with eight.
Maggot on third and five is in the backfield behind Bledsoe. He comes straight back this time. Bledsoe for Jefferson. Pass is almost intercepted. No flags. No flags. Tyrone Williams, who's really starting to come on.
Yeah, remember, back there. Remember that interception that Tyrone Williams had in the championship game, that one-handed interception? I tell you, because Jefferson has a step on him. Bledsoe threw that ball a little short. Sean Jefferson runs a 4-3. I mean, he'd be one of the fastest guys in football. And when he runs like that, you have to get it out there in front of him.
Desmond Howard back deep. Tom Tupa. Punts trying to keep it away from Howard, who says he tries to make the first man miss, and he did it again, but not the second. As the Patriot coverage was good, Mike Bartram was down. Last play of the first quarter. Favre underhanded to Dorsey Levins, backhanded, underhanded, an Uncle Rube shot.
Pretty good first quarter we just had. 28 points, 24 points in the first quarter.
If that's just pretty good.
Well, that's great. That's, if you like points, if you like scoring, if you like offense, we've had it all. We had a little running, passing, trick plays, bootlegs, long passes.
That had everything.
Not much pass rush, though.
Second down. Far. Incomplete. Intended for Jackson, and there is no flag. Keith obviously thought there should have been one.
Yeah, look at this, how Green Bay started off. Two plays right off the bat, then they got their touchdown. That was Andre Rison. Then they got an interception, a turnover. They had four plays, and then, you know, they had their 10 points right off the bat. And then after that, there was two, three and outs, and now they're on their third one, and their third one on third down.
Third and six, four wide receivers for the Packers. Favre's pass incomplete.
Yeah, that's that same defense, Pat. That's that dime defense where the Patriots put in Teddy Bruschi, three defensive linemen, and seven defensive backs. There you have Slade coming from one side, Jones up the middle, McGinnis from the other side. But look at all those defensive backs back there.
Back to punt is Hendrick and Dave Meggett back deep for New England. This one slides off the side of his foot. Meggett has to let it bounce. It takes a Patriot bounce and then a Green Bay bounce. The New England Patriots leading Mike Holmgren's Packers 14-10.
You know, Drew Bledsoe was in the huddle, and there's Drew Bledsoe right here. He just ran over to the sideline, talked to his coaches, and then came back in. I'm not sure when the time clock started, but he does have 20 seconds on the play clock, so he's okay.
First and 10, Patriots from their own 42. And Bledsoe back to throw. And throws it away. Reggie White in pursuit along with Wayne Simmons. Here's what Bledsoe has done so far.
But you know, and again, if you look at all his successful passes, they all start with play fakes. Excellent play fake, and then after the play fake, he's also getting excellent pass protection. See, but every one of these successful plays had started with a play fake where he fakes the run and then comes out and makes a pass.
And he hides the ball so well.
That's because his dad was a coach. He said he learned how to do that before he could eat cereal.
Here he is, straight drop back, incomplete. Intended for Ben Coates. That really is still his go-to guy. When nobody else is open, he'll throw it in Coates' direction.
And here's the guy that they have to block if they're going to throw it to Reggie. I mean, if they're going to throw it to Coach. You see what Reggie can do? You see, Max Lane got there, and he wasn't ready for him. So if you don't do that, what Reggie White just did,
to Max Lane there was what he calls a bull rush.
You better
and
get
if you're
ready.
If you're back, if he looks and you're on your heels, he's just going to get underneath and just drive you right back into the quarterback with his bull rush.
Four wide receivers. Reggie took the inside path. Bledsoe is hit just as he lets it go. A blitz from the other side by Doug Evans off the corner.
Yeah, well, that's what Fritz Schirmer said. He wasn't getting there with his four, so what you start doing, here's Reggie. He's going to take an inside. Then you're going to see the blitz coming from the outside by Doug Evans. See, Reggie White, he takes the inside. That's the right side. Watch the backside. See, it was Doug Evans. The minute that Bledsoe saw him, he knew he had to get rid of the ball. See, Evans is out there like he was going to cover Terry Glenn, and then he just took off, and he was at Drew Bledsoe's backside or blind side.
Tupa back to punt. Good kick. Howard handles. First man didn't miss again. Super Bowl 31, New England 14, Green Bay 10. We're in the second quarter, and things seem to have settled down just a bit, John.
Yeah, and here's Green Bay's problem is this first down area. In fact, on first down, you look here, their average has been minus 1.8. So they've been ending up in second and long and third and long, and they can't really do anything against that dime defense.
Here's Favre. Antonio Freeman, they're not going to catch him. Touchdown, Green Bay, as the Packers recapture the lead. A strike from Favre.
That's the answer to first down. If you're going minus 1.8 yards, just go for the deep one, go on a strike. Here's Antonio Freeman out here, and you just watch him right here. He starts out and he just runs right by his guy, and Brett Favre throws a perfect strike to him.
The longest touchdown pass in Super Bowl history, 81 yards.
He was
Favre to Freeman.
He got on Lawyer Malloy, number 36, who is a strong safety.
And the Packers recapture the lead. Favre, reason to celebrate. Back at Super Bowl 31, Green Bay 17, New England 14.
Antonio Freeman got on Lawyer Malloy. Lawyer Malloy is a strong safety, and he got, because Antonio Freeman was in the slot, he had to play a man-to-man. Antonio Freeman got by him and ran right by him, and the free safety, Willie Clay, never did get over there.
As we said, that 81-yard touchdown pass, the longest in Super Bowl history by a yard. That's Dave Meggett. Meggett gets out to about the 24. John?
Well, just here's Antonio Freeman. Here's Lawyer Malloy. Here's Willie Clay. He should be the help. He should get over there. He gets right by him and runs right by Malloy on the line of scrimmage right there. You see it there? And then Clay right back here doesn't get over, and Brett Favre throws a perfect strike.
And Antonio Freeman separates.
Right, and they were having trouble throwing on second and third down. So what they did is they started throwing on first down. That's what Bill Parcells is telling Lawyer Malloy there. You know, that we got to watch out for those deep ones on first down. And if you're going to get up there, you got to bump them.
Bledsoe, pass caught. That's Terry Glenn.
Lawyer Malloy is one of those guys that came out of college, and in college he was a linebacker, you know, a blitzer. And you know, he knew how to play press coverage, and he knew how to play tight coverage, and he knew how to blitz, but he really wasn't good on the deep coverage. That time he wasn't good on the tight coverage because he got up there on Antonio Freeman and he didn't even hit him or touch him, or he just whipped at him.
Second and one. That's Curtis Martin, who hammers it up just enough for the first down past the 35-yard line.
Big old 93 there, Gilbert Brown, weighs 350 pounds, and you're going to run up the middle.
Oh, you're kind to him, I think.
Well, 370 pounds then. You know, I mean, he gets a couple of those triples in him, but he's tough to move.
Oh, boy.
And then they're going to run right at him, and you think, how in the heck can they do that? Here he is right here, and you have to move that pile in order to run. Well, you start off by double teaming it, and you just get a little push.
Here's Bledsoe on the play fake again. All kinds of time, he finally throws it away. as Reggie White finally broke into his face. But that's good protection.
Yeah, and what happened is they had good coverage downfield because they were trying to get Sean Jefferson deep all the way across that time. He was the only guy deep, and the Packers down there had three guys on him. See, here's what they're trying to do. They get Sean Jefferson a bump here. Now watch at the end. That's who he's trying to throw to. He's looking for Sean Jefferson, and right there, by that time, the ball is gone.
Second and 10. Colts comes in motion. A draw play to Martin. And they wrap him up after he picked up a couple. The Patriots at their own 37-yard line, 38 perhaps.
You know, so far, this has kind of been a passing game.
Yeah.
Combined yardage has been, passing has been 278 yards and 16 yards running. So the first half of this game is a passing game.
Well, it's artificial turf. It's flat. It's a controlled atmosphere. It's indoors.
And you have Drew Bledsoe and Brett Favre.
And here's Bledsoe back to throw it. Down he goes from behind. Off the corner, Leroy Butler.
That was the thing we said, that Fritz Schirmer, the defensive coordinator, was having trouble with his regular pass rush, so he starts bringing guys. Here's Leroy Butler there. He comes up to the outside. You see, he just runs right over Dave Meggett. That's the thing that people try to do to Dave Meggett. They want to get him out as a third down pass receiver, but then they blitz and make him a blocker.
Butler rushed the passer like a lineman.
Well, when he saw Dave Meggett there, he knew he had a physical mismatch.
Tupa's kick by Howard at the 19. He's got some room. Desmond Howard into New England territory. No flags, and the Packers will take over. Second quarter. Green Bay 17, Brett Favre 5 out of 9, 2 touchdowns, 158 yards, most of it on 2 completions.
Well, and first down play. Remember the last time they got that Antonio Freeman? That was a pass on first down. I wouldn't be surprised if they passed again on first down right here.
That's Bennett.
Bennett.
Neither team able to get much going on the ground.
Now, and especially on first down, we showed that graphic where the Packers were minus 1.8 on first down because they're really ganging up against the run on first down, and that's the best time to pass, because the Packers had fallen into that thing where the Patriots would play good first down defense and then they'd play nickel on second and dime on third, and they really couldn't solve that. So they started throwing on first down, which I thought was an excellent idea.
Second and 9. Bennett and Henderson, the runners. And here's Favre throwing on second. Up the middle, open is Risen. Risen out of bounds at the New England 24. You think coaches can sometimes get hung up on, I know they always say to us, we got to establish the run. You think you can get hung up on that?
Yeah, I think you can, and just stay with it too long. But you don't want to become one-dimensional. But when you have an Andre Risen on one side and an Antonio Freeman on the other side, and they can run free like this, just run where you get behind the linebackers and in front of the secondary, you might as well just do that all day. I'll tell you one thing. We talked with Andre Risen the other day, and he is one happy football player.
First down throw. A misread between Risen and Favre.
I think that's where Favre just had a chance to just throw the ball out of the ball yard. Remember, he said in high school he used to do that. He said he'd be out in the outfield, he would just throw the ball as hard as he could.
Andre Risen caught the pass. Antonio Freeman saying, hey, that was not a pick.
Well, he didn't want a pick, but what he was doing is he didn't want to clip because Andre Risen was coming across towards him.
Four wide receivers. They start Freeman in motion. Favre gets to the Levens, and Levens picks up a Packer first down. Malloy tripped him up at the 11.
And that's why you want to stay with the run, just to have it there enough so that they have to play the run.
because if you become one dimensional and they start pass rushing all the time, then you don't have a chance. So you get them to pass rush, and then you run the trap, and you give the ball to Dorsey Levins, who's one of the hottest players in football. Well, there's only two teams in football right now, but
yeah, that's right.
Over the last month, I mean, Dorsey Levins has become one of the biggest threats on this team.
One of the reasons they're here is because he's so hot. First down, Green Bay at the New England 12. Just barely got it off. This is Bennett, and he is taken down back at the 15. Lawyer Malloy.
And Ty Law, he's the corner on that side too. So that's one thing that this Patriot defense has is they have good tacklers back there. Law and Malloy and Clay and Otis Smith, they all tackle pretty well. The trouble they have, it looks like, is with speed, that you may not be able to run over them or run through them, but you can run by them.
Malloy and Law, two players, two young players that Bill Parcells feels have the equipment to be stars for a long time in the NFL. Here's Favre. Screen pass, drop, intended for Levin. It was low.
Well, he had Chris Slade on him, and Chris Slade made him throw that pass low. You know, we talked about a screen pass, how you kind of let the rusher come and you invite him. But watch Slade right here, number 53. Earl Dotson doesn't get enough of him. And then Brett Favre has to throw that ball over Slade. And that's where he had the problem, because he was throwing the screen to the right. And if you're going to throw to that side, you better get that guy's hands down. You have to cut him to throw a screen to his side.
Third and 13 there, 0 for the ball.
The Packers want timeout. Mike Holmgren's trying to get timeout. He didn't get it.
Favre throw up into the pocket. Incomplete, out of the end zone. Rising, the intended receiver, couldn't get high enough.
That was interesting, Pat. I was watching Mike Holmgren on the sideline before that play, and he was trying to get a timeout. He didn't want to run that third down play. It would have been interesting had it been a touchdown. Let's see if we can see it here. You see he's signaling. You see he's signaling timeout there. He wanted the timeout. He's watching the clock. He didn't get the timeout. And now, of course, he got an incomplete pass, and now he has to go for the field goal.
Jacke is good from 31 yards out, and the Packers lead 20-14. A lot of fireworks.
Yeah, 34 points of fireworks, and Drew Bledsoe looks like he's getting ready to go again, and he's had all that success. We showed all his success, and it's been with those play action passes where he fakes a run and throws a pass, or where he fakes a run and bootlegs another direction.
Eight plays, 33 yards, a 31-yard field goal by Chris Jacke. Mike Holmgren, as you said, tried to call a timeout and just couldn't get it. Wound up with 3 points.
Yeah, we talk about the players in this game and the quarterbacks in this game and the linemen, but I'll tell you, we also have two of the best coaches. Not only the best coaches in the game today, but I think in Bill Parcells, who's already won two Super Bowls, and Mike Holmgren on the Packers side, I think two of the best coaches that have coached in a long time. I mean, I think that put them up there with the top coaches of any time.
Both great motivators in different ways. This is Megan. And he is taken down by Bernardo Harris.
This can continue to be high scoring as long as you don't get separation. I think if you start getting separation where one team starts getting way ahead by more than two touchdowns, then I think they go into a conservative mode. I think the other team goes into a press mode.
First down, Bledsoe up the middle, Coates complete. And about the 43, Eugene Robinson.
Well, did Bledsoe throw that ball? He looked like Dan Marino on that one. He just had that thing up there and whipped it in there, and Ben Coates just pulled it right out of the air. I mean, that was something that looked like the way you're supposed to do it. That was almost perfect pass there. I mean, he got back, he set up, and he whipped that thing, and Coach just went whack and just took it right out of the air. Woo. That was a good-looking play.
First and 10 at the 44. Patriots in their own territory, but Again, it's been success on first down for both teams. Blitz coming. Bledsoe has hit it. They tried to hit Byers, but from around the corner came Butler.
And that's the same area that they had problems with Butler from before. He's coming from that backside of Bledsoe. You see him right there. And see, Bledsoe is looking to the right, and Leroy Butler hits him right in the back. That's the third time that Butler has come from that position.
And successfully. Second and 10. Patriots at their own 44-yard line. The Packers, since they started a blitz, have given Bledsoe problems. No blitz this time. Pass intercepted by Mike Pryor. Pryor stays on his feet. Pryor gets the Packers back to the 26. Scuffle breaks out for a moment. Mike Pryor with the interception shuts down Bledsoe and the Patriots.
You see what Bledsoe did? He was faking to the right, then he was going to bring it back to the left, but he had to pump it one more time. He was trying to get it deep to Sean Jefferson. He was leading Jefferson, but he let it right into Pryor. But that wasn't where he was going to go with the ball the first time. He wanted to go to the right, had good coverage out there to the right, and he had to come back to the left. And really, when he came back to the left, didn't take a good look at it.
So the Packers take over, and don't forget that story, the turnovers. In a game of this magnitude, they are always big. And the Patriots have turned it over twice.
You know, yesterday when we were talking to Bill Parcells, he says, if we don't get any turnovers, we're not going to win. And they still have plenty of time to play to get turnovers.
Favre looked deep. Has a man on the sideline. As Jackson. A fumble, and let's see who got it. The official says he was down.
I don't know why players do that. I know what Keith Jackson's trying to do. The way they spot the ball is when your knee goes down, it's not where your knee goes down, it's where the ball is when your knee goes down. So what players try and do is they try and reach out as far as they can, but then they don't have any strength and that ball gets knocked out of there a lot. That's a very dangerous thing.
So many times you see that happen.
And what he was trying to do, he was successful in. He was trying to stretch to get a first down, which he did.
But he almost lost the ball. First down. To Edgar Bennett, who's knocked backwards by Todd Collins.
And Ted Johnson was there too, both Johnson and Collins. The other thing is just watch Ted Johnson here. I mean he's the type of guy, he said he always takes on with his right shoulder, and then he just throws his body at that runner, and he has one of the biggest necks that I've ever seen. I mean, he doesn't have a big head and he doesn't have, you know, big shoulders and stuff, but his neck is size 20.
Doesn't matter which shoulder he takes it on with.
Well, he says he does everything with his right shoulder. That's why he just has the band on his right arm.
That was rising in motion. The pass intended for Freeman, a flag on the play. .531 left to play in the first half. Green Bay leading 20-14. Jerry Austin indicates first down Green Bay.
Number 45 of the defense, first down.
Otis Smith, the offender.
Yeah, you see Otis Smith right here playing the slant. You see Antonio Freeman starts to the outside, then he goes inside, and instead of, see, if Otis Smith were to put his left foot up there, he wouldn't have to put his left hand up there. Well, we got his left foot back. He had to put his left hand up there. Mike Holmgren, it looks like, kind of saw that the whole way, didn't he?
Let's see what they do on first down here. Far back to throw it. In the middle of Freeman.
Yeah, it was interesting. He was trying to go. He was trying to go out here to Andre Rison.
Yep.
He wanted to look. He was looking at Andre Rison out on the left side, and he came back to Antonio Freeman. Here's Freeman, and he's going to come across the field. See, he's going to come up, then he's going to turn in and see Brett Favre, and then Brett Favre's going to hit him right there. He was his second receiver. He was looking first to the left to Andre Rison. Here's the one that he was trying to hit, Andre Rison against Otis Smith.
You see what happened? He had that, plus he had help deep.
First down. At the Patriot 34, Favre.
11.
And Levens hammers down inside the 25.
You see on that sweep, you know, they always talk about a running back and how he has to have patience. Levens had patience on that play. He's going to start on a sweep. Now watch Brett Favre after he hands off. He's going to go and he's going to make a jump fake. But watch Levens right here. He has patience, patience, patience. And then right when he sees it, whack, he turns that thing up in there. But you don't just slash and run right at it. You come out, you let your guards get out there. You have patience to wait for them. Then after they get out there and make their commitment, then you hit it.
Second and one. That was the old familiar Green Bay sweep, just different people. Levens inside the 20. First down, Green Bay. Now they're starting to run it a little bit.
You know, defensive players love it when their offense runs the ball, because that means that the offense is controlling it and the defensive guys get to get a little rest. The worst thing for a defensive player is three and out offensively, their offense.
The Packers, two opportunities inside the red zone, inside the 20. They've gotten two field goals by Jacke. First down. This is Edgar Bennett.
This is Bennett.
Bennett tried to cut it back, got to about the line of scrimmage, maybe a yard before Otis Smith came up to make the stop.
The Packers are doing a lot of things, changing in. Don Beebe was in that time. Andre Rison comes out. They're going one tight end, two tight ends. Now they're putting Beebe back in, and I would expect that this would be a three wide receiver formation. That's one thing about Mike Holmgren, who calls the plays. He gives you a lot of different looks.
Levens is the lone back this time.
And this is a three wide receiver look.
Right. And a handoff is to Dorsey Levens. He gets it in the corner, out of bounds. At about the 10-yard line, maybe a yard shy of the first, knocked out by Ty Law.
Now you can tell the frustration in Bill Parcells now, because he wants that ball back. But I tell you, they had good blocking on that right side that time. See, this is a coach here who wants to get the ball back. And what he's saying, you see, is when you run and you're running a sweep to the outside, you have to get force to the upside, to outside the side they're running to, and he had no force on that play.
Favre headed over to the sideline. We're going to get the 2-minute warning. Yes, there are some Packer backers in Kill, Mississippi. That's Brett Favre's hometown, about 60 miles from here.
And I think all Kill, Mississippi is Packer backers. I don't think there's just a few from Kill. I mean, everyone, if you're from Kill, Mississippi, you're a Packer backer and you're a Favre backer. That's not a bad deal.
And you can be a cheesehead from Kill.
And you can be like a half and half.
Yes, you could, if you so chose to.
You know, if you had to say, are there more Packer fans here or Patriot fans here, which would you guess?
I'd say Packer.
Sounds like it.
Although, based on the noise outside the room last night, Patriots fan. This is Levens to the two. Dorsey Levens, in the last couple of weeks, the last couple of games, has really developed into a force.
And you're going to see him here just come out and just take the ball out there. You see he's going to have a lead block. He gets the lead in the four hole, bounces it out, gets a good block there for Mark Shimura, and then just turns it up the field. But when you have a good blocking tight end like number 89 there, Shimura, who on that play gets two, you can always get a soft corner on the strong side or the side of your tight end. Now the Packers want to take their time here to score this touchdown.
From the two, first and goal. Here's Favre. Pointing, and Favre pushed. Didn't get in.
Maybe he did. One official said he did get in.
Yes, he thinks he did.
Remember, it's where the ball is. And it looked like the ball was inside the pylon and did break the plane.
And the pylon's in the end zone, out of bounds.
But the ball was inside. And we talked about players stretching to get that ball, put that ball where it's going to be. That time, Brett Favre stretched it into the end zone. Mark Shimura there, who made the good block on that play before, has a tattoo, the Superman tattoo. He's been blocking like Superman.
Jacke for the extra point right down the middle. Green Bay 27. New England 14.
We're just talking about Brett Favre and Kill Mississippi, and this is the way they do. Remember, it's a goal line there, and the ball has to break the plane. You see him reach out, and here's the ball right here, and it has to break the plane of the goal line. This official's right there. He sees it. He calls it a touchdown. The pylon is already down. The pylon is out of bounds. His knee is out of bounds there.
But he got the ball in the corner of the end zone.
Right. It's where the ball is, where his knee goes down. And there's Irv Favre right there. He knew it. He said, that's a touchdown. That's my kid. He was his high school coach. And he said that's what he taught him. Anytime I run with the ball, he said, that's what I learned from my dad. Said, because we used a split tee and a wishbone in high school. And he said he was a running quarterback there. So yeah. He said he tells his dad, anytime that he runs with a ball and does anything running, he said that's for him. That's what he taught him. The passing part, not so much.
The passing part, who takes credit for that?
I'd give that to Mike Holmgren.
Well, he does that pretty well, too. This is Dave Meggett out of the end zone. And Meggett is cut down at about the 22. The pass from Bledsoe, first down Patriots.
And Drew Bledsoe has found something there. Remember the last time the Patriots had the ball, they hit Ben Coates right in that middle, right in that same area. Now if they can keep their pass protection, they can do that all the time, because that's an area that they found open that they can do some work there. Let's watch Ben Coates. He's right here, and he's going to come up, and here's the area that he wants to get to, and he's going to work in this middle. You see, the Packers are in a zone, and that's what you try and do with your tight end, is work the middle. You see, he gets a bump there, pushes off, but look how open that middle is once he gets by the original bump of Leroy Butler. You see, now watch, he's going to get bumped right there by Butler. He pushes Butler off,
yep.
And watch how open that whole area. I mean, there's a 10-yard hole in there after he gets by Butler that they can do some business in there.
Got a first down. It's first and 10. 58 seconds left to play in the first half. The Patriots have two timeouts left.
And right now, Bill Parcells is looking for a whole lot of places he can do some business.
Three-man front for Green Bay. But the blitz comes. And the Patriots will get another first down to Terry Glenn, or close to it, right at midfield. Eugene Robinson made the stop. Bledsoe said, let's hurry. It is a first down.
Patriots still have two timeouts.
Right. Bledsoe to throw. Drops it off to Martin. Good defensive play as Dave Meggett, I beg your pardon.
And they're going to have to use one of their timeouts now. And the first thing they have to think about is get about 15 yards to get in field goal range.
That was Butler who made the defensive play.
Yeah, that's the first thing that you want to do. Is you'd like to score a touchdown here. But you think first things first. So you need 15 more yards to get in field goal range. Then after you get your 15 yards, then you try and get closer, and then you go for the end zone. But you don't have to go for the end zone or the touchdown until you get in field goal range.
Adam Vinatieri has hit from 50 yards. 35 seconds left. New England has one timeout remaining. They'd like to save it if they can get close enough for their kicker.
You know, one thing about a Fritz Schirmer defense, when they get in these situations, he will go to a three-man line, play a soft zone. So you don't get a big pass rush here, but you have to throw against eight.
That's what they're doing now. That's all gets Vincent Brisby, and he gets out of bounds, and that stops the clock with 30 seconds left in the first half.
Yeah, see, and the Packers really won that one in the first and second. They completed, the Patriots have completed two passes, but they still have third and three. Now they have to complete another one. Now, instead of thinking field goal, right now they have to think first down. Get out of bounds.
And they'll go with a three-man front. You have to be alert for Meggett on a draw play, which he runs very well. But no draw. It's incomplete to Bledsoe.
And right now, I think the Patriots have to go fourth down. I think that they'll go for it on fourth down again. See, if they had some timeouts left, they could have run the ball twice here to get a first down. But now, I think they have to go again. They're only fourth and two or three. So we're talking about a pass that will get them about 3 yards is what they need right here.
Obviously too far for a Vinatieri field goal. It would be 60 yards.
They better watch out because that play clock's down to 10 seconds.
26 seconds on the game clock. Bledsoe gets back in time. Dotson broke free up the middle, and the Packers almost came up with a ball. If they didn't, the ball hit the carpet.
Now Fritz Sherman knew who they were going to.
Yep.
He knew that on fourth down. Remember, Bill Parcells did that, a big fourth down where he went to Ben Coates. He was trying to do it again there. I think if you had a guess, they needed that fourth down. They needed to get the first down, and the guy to do it was going to be Ben Coates. And Fritz Sherman knew that.
Now
Bill Parcells knew it.
Now Mike Holmgren's got 19 seconds in all of his timeouts,
and now he can go for it. But look what they did to Ben Coates. You see, Leroy Butler has him here, and he just grabs him. And then the inside guy comes and hits him.
Here's trying to, here's Favre taken down, and now they'll probably just sit on it. Clock down to 14 seconds as Favre is sacked.
Yeah, it looks like, in fact, I just saw Mike Holmgren just took his headset off, so that means he's going to let this clock run out and just take his team inside and say 27-14. That's pretty good when you're playing for the world championship.
Indeed it is. Packers will be on offense first in the second half, and this is Desmond Howard. A couple of outstanding returns in the first half, and Howard out of bounds at about the 24, where Green Bay will take over.
You know, we talked about momentum, how Green Bay had it initially, and then New England took it away from them, then Green Bay got it back, and now New England, again, if they're going to stay in the game, they have to get it back here, and they have to start right here with their defense. And the way that they started it in the first part of the game was stopping them on first down, getting them in second and third and long, then playing that dime defense.
And then Green Bay started to throw on first down.
And I wouldn't be surprised if Mike Holmgren looked at that and made that same adjustment and started to throw on first down again.
Yep. Here's Favre. The rollout. Shimura. Favre's roommate for about seven.
Yeah, and that's the way to do it. You know, I mean, to come out there and throw on first down and get, you know, 5 or 6 yards. Because if you look how they did on their passing distance from 0 to 5, the real short yard, they were 3 out of 5, 6 to 10, 1 out of 1, 11 to 15 yards, 1 out of 4. And then they said they were going to take their strikes, and they did, 3 out of 5 for 157 yards.
They need 2 for a first. Packers at their own 32. That's Bennett, and Edgar Bennett finds a hole outside, gets a Packer first down outside their own 40, stopped by Malloy.
You know who's a tricky blocker is Frank Winters, the center for the Packers. He never gets a lot of credit. You don't talk about him a lot, but he's one of those guys. Watch him right here, how he'll get into his guy, get him turned. The ball's coming out here, but he has all the tricks. I mean, see him get in there, boom, 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 let the guy penetrate,
yep,
and then turn him, or just as a running back gets there.
He gets in some odd positions, but it turns out being effective. Here's Favre on first. To Henderson, who gets outside the 45, about the 46 and a half. Ted Johnson brought him down.
I always thought that Mike Holmgren was one of the best second half coaches. You know, that
I agree.
Going in, making adjustments, coming out in the second half. And you can see 2 first downs they've had in the second half, and they've passed both of them. Because when he tried the other way, that didn't work, and he knows that as well as anyone.
There are some coaches, John, who just can't do that. They can't adjust at the half.
No, and
some good coaches.
And there are some coaches that are good coaches are not just good game coaches.
Right.
Mike Holmgren is a good game coach. Bill Parcells is a good game coach. They know how to play the game.
Bennett. Favre gives to Henderson again. And he's up to about the 40. Well, now they're still checking the goalpost.
Yeah, they were checking the height of it. You know, someone, remember Antonio Freeman?
Yeah.
He scored down there. I don't know if he bent that goalpost or not, but they checked the height of it, but they also checked that it's straight. And that looked like a little out of kilter to someone.
Well, there was a lot of noise at the half. Maybe it got rocking.
And look at the smoke is still in here. There's a lot of pyro stuff. Maybe the pyro pumped it out.
Third and short. Far on third and short. Shimura again. First down, Green Bay.
Yeah, in the first half, it looked like Brett Favre was going to his running backs and to his wide receivers. And now in the second half, one of the other adjustments they make is to start to get the tight end in the passing game.
Let's go back and look at what you were talking about with Antonio Freeman.
Yeah, remember he jumped up and he hit the goalpost there. Now that could have knocked it out of straight.
He looked like he hit it hard enough.
Well, yeah, but it just bent it a little, maybe. Yeah, and he does have a big cast on his arm. You know, he has that plate in his arm.
On first down, that's Dorsey Levens, and he got maybe a yard.
You know,
Drew Bledsoe getting ready. Excuse me.
And he knows that he has to get that momentum back. Now, that's the first time in this second half that the Packers ran on first down. Now, the Patriots are starting to get them in situation they want. Second and long, and then they can go a nickel and then hope they can stop him here and then go to that dime defense that has really given the Packers some problems.
Second and nine. They come with five down linemen this time. But one of them is a linebacker. He'll back out. No, he comes. Slade. Wheels it to Henderson. And Henderson, a yard shy of the first down, the ball comes out, but he was down Willie McGinst.
Yeah, that's their form of a zone blitz. Willie McGinst is the right end, and what he does is he drop out. See, here's McGinst right here, and he starts out, then he drops out. Now on the other side, they're blitzing, so they overload the left side away from Willie McGinst. And then Willie McGinst, he starts like he's going to be a pass rusher, and then he drops out. So that's their form of the zone blitz. Didn't do any good, though, did it?
Nope. Third and short. Eighth play of the drive coming. Levens. And with that last lunge, I think he got the first down.
Bill Parcells is hoping for a spot here because we talked about momentum. He knows that his team has to get it back. The Packers know that they can't give it up. And every inch like this in a short yardage is a big deal.
Where they put the ball down, he didn't get the first down. Where they marked it, I thought with the last little backward lunge by Levens, he got it.
And I would think if they don't get it here, I wouldn't be surprised if the Packers would go for it. And if they do go for it, I wouldn't be surprised if it's a quarterback sneak, because Brett Favre is a good quarterback sneaker. He says what he does on the quarterback sneak is he looks for the sweet spot. Frank Winters, the center, will tell him which way to go. Now, in the last game, we'd see Frank Winters give him a signal. Yep. He would tap the right side or the left side which way to go.
This is one time you'd like to be a good sneaker. But the ball is given to Levens, and he doesn't get anywhere near the line of scrimmage, stopped by Ted Johnson. The Crescent City of New Orleans in Super Bowl 31.
You know, here's what I always liked about Ted Johnson, Pat, that he plays up the field. Now watch, he's the guy that gets the penetration there that stops Dorsey Levens. You see him get the penetration right there, and that is a big, big play for the Patriots.
First and 10, New England at their own 44. Bledsoe back to throw it on first down. Fire, complete. Sean Jefferson makes the catch. Defended by Evans.
Yeah. I was watching Leroy Butler, and he was between Drew Bledsoe and Sean Jefferson, and Bledsoe threw it right over Butler's head. See if we can see it in this picture here. Here's Sean Jefferson. He just stops in the hook, and Leroy Butler was between him and Bledsoe, and it looked like he was in position where he could pick it off. Watch him go up. Well, in fact, it did hit his hand.
Yeah.
I thought so, because I was watching. I thought maybe he was going to intercept it.
Bledsoe again. Pass complete to Byers.
Byers didn't see Brian Williams there, did he? Byers caught that ball, but that's what you have to do. If you're going to catch the ball inside there, you're going to get hit anyway, so there's no need to look. So he was looking at the ball, concentrating the ball, and whack, little Brian Williams gave him one in there.
Notice that all the players, excuse me, John, are wearing an emblem on their helmets with the word, with the name Pete, in honor of the late Pete Rozelle. Here's Bledsoe. And again, I think deflected. Intended for Coates.
And again, that's Leroy Butler was in there, so he's been deflecting a lot of them. And there's that Pete you were talking about, of course, for Pete Rozelle. And I've always felt that Pete Rozelle was not only the best commissioner that football ever had, but the any best sport. Commissioner that any sport ever had. I think that every Super Bowl is really a tribute and a legacy to Pete Rozelle.
Yeah, you can wear that emblem every game, really. Third down. Bledsoe to throw. They pick up Butler. Bledsoe for Jefferson, just over and out of his reach.
It was pretty good. Is that Tyrone Williams? It seems like,
yeah,
you know, that every time they put him in, and he's their rookie nickel back, and he's out there playing on speed. Again, Jefferson being one of the fastest guys in the league, he's running 4.3 40, and he gets by him there. And again, that one was just an inch or two too much. They've made it as to pick up the blitz. I mean, that's a big thing that Butler is doing now. Remember, we saw earlier where Leroy Butler ran over Megan. That time Megan got him blocked.
Tupa aims for out of bounds. Fair catch signal by Desmond Howard at the 11. He made it there. Right now, the Super Bowl has 8:07 left, third quarter, with the Packers leading 27-14.
And the Patriots, again, their defense has to try and get the momentum back. They had a pretty good shot on that last time when Ted Johnson came up with that big fourth down play to stop him. Their offense couldn't do anything. And now they have him backed up, and this is where if you can get a big play by your defense and create a turnover, that can become a score very easily.
First down at the 12 for Green Bay, their own 12. Favre to throw, he comes to Blitz off the corner. Oh, Otis Smith, and nobody saw him coming, including Brett Favre.
You could see it all the way from up here. Otis Smith was lined up on the outside receiver, and you're going to see him come from the outside. Here he is right there. He lined up like he was going to cover. It was Brett Favre's backside. There's Otis Smith right there. He looks like he's going to cover. Brett Favre is looking to the right. Then he looks in the middle. I think when he looked in the middle, just out of the shade of his left eye, he saw Otis Smith.
Second and 17.
The Patriots needed a big defensive play down there. They just got one. Now they need another one.
Pump fake. Looking for Antonio Freeman. The pump fake didn't fool anybody.
That was interesting there, wasn't it? That Otis Smith came on a blitz and knocked Favre down and got a sack on him. So then Brett Favre went to work on Otis Smith, having to cover on the next play. Otis Smith just won both of those battles.
They needed big plays from the defense. They got the first one you pointed out. They just got another one, an incompletion. And how far? Well, this will be an interesting choice right here on third and 17.
They're staying in their regular offense, so now the Patriots don't go to their dime defense.
Brett Favre gets to Bennett. And they move the pile out to about the 10. They don't get a first down, but they do get their punter a little bit more room.
And if special teams are going to play a big part in this game for the Patriots, if Dave Megan is going to do something, he needs one right here. I mean, here's where he can really pick up field position for his team.
Hendrick standing back in the end zone. Be interesting to see if the Patriots put a return on or try to block it.
I would think they'd put a return on.
They did. And it's a good kick. And Megan will field it at the 42-yard line. And the Packers are down in a hurry and do a good job covering, and New England takes over at their own 48.
All the Packers are doing now, the Packers have them one-dimensional, and they're just playing pass.
Curtis Martin.
There's your run.
Midfield, there's a run.
Yep, 14 straight passes, and then they go to the run.
And 5 yards they got.
And then I think because if they run and they can run, then they can get their play passes and some stuff going. That's Ted Johnson. I think that their middle linebacker has probably played as well as anyone. on that Patriot defense today. I like him. He's a very impressive guy. He's a good guy.
Second and six. He was. He is. Here's Bledsoe back to throw. Up into the pocket is Bledsoe, and taken down from behind by Sean Jones as he tried to run it.
What's Sean Jones here? Now, once you start up the field, the worst place you can be is behind a quarterback. And then when he starts running up, you have to make that move to come around him. You see, he's going to start inside on a pass rush, and then he's there. Now, when he feels that run, you turn and you wheel and you go back up the field. Some defensive linemen just stand there, they keep running. The good ones wheel when they see the quarterback run.
Third and five. No flag. Bledsoe. Had two shots at it and got it on the second chance. First down. Robinson and Butler had him sandwiched, but Coates still came up with it.
That's one of the things you tell receivers, to catch your ball with your hands out in front of you. I'll tell you, Leroy Butler is just mugging him, and Coates just gets it because the ball got so close to it, he hit him in the shoulder pads. Watch him block on Reggie White here. Here's Reggie White here. You see, there's Max Lane, and he was trying to do that hump move to him, and he got just enough help from Rucci, his right guard. Just gave him just enough help.
Just a little chip. 5 minutes left in the third quarter. Bledsoe has a reverse coming. Faked it, and now he's going to throw to Martin. Can't hang on. Had it settling in one hand for just a second.
You know, Bill Parcells told us yesterday that he has two special plays, or two surprise plays, to take a shot. That was one of them right there, the fake reverse and pass to Curtis Martin. He has one more there on that sheet somewhere. In fact, he was telling us what he has on that sheet.
Yeah.
He has 6 runs, 3 draws, 5 play actions, 2 bootlegs, 3 screens, 2 special plays, and 15 drop back passes.
And if he gets them all run, they've had a big day. Here's Bledsoe. Fires to Jefferson. Makes the catch very, very close to a Patriot first down. He's hit by Tyrone Williams.
Yeah, it's an interesting thing. Both Santana Dotson and Reggie White are taking themselves out. I don't understand that. I mean, this is a time that you have to stop them, and they both raise their hand and come walking off the field. Yeah, that's you know, the only thing that I can think of is that it is getting a little hot down there.
Mm-hmm. McKenzie and Wilkins went in to take their place. Gilbert Brown started out and then went back. They're that much short of the first down. You don't want Gilbert Brown out, do you?
Well, they can't take them all out. I mean, if Reggie's going to come out and Santana Dotson's going to come out, Gilbert Brown can't come out. There's Santana Dotson, number 71. I saw them. They both raised their hands and walked out.
Well, it must be getting hot down there.
Well, you know, and then they had all that exhaust is still in here. They had fireworks. They had Harley Davidsons. They had everything. And it's still sitting in this dome.
Are you okay?
No, I'm fine. I'm not down there in the field, but I think down there in the field it's getting hot for these
guys. It's starting to settle.
I think they're starting to feel the wear and tear in the heat.
Third and short. Martin deep. He gets the carry, and he's got more. Then enough for the first inside the 20. Still on his feet, struggles down to about the 17. Stopped by Eugene Robinson.
Yeah, that's the old deal. When the cat's away, the mice play. You know, they take out Santana Dotson. They take out Reggie White. They need a little running. They get the lead there. There's Keith Byers on the lead, and there was no one there. I mean, that was a hole that anyone could have ran through. But again, just by getting enough running, and the Patriots are doing now, then they can get all their stuff going.
Packer down on the play. I think it's Craig Newsome. Let's check in with Bill Maas.
Hey, Pat, I'll tell you, it is getting hot down here. As you look up into the ceiling, you see nothing but a fog. And I think it's because of the air conditioning ducts are all covered up around the sides of the stadium. They're covered up with the banners. So the air's having trouble getting out of here. Back up to you, Pat.
Thanks, Bill. First and 10 on the Green Bay 18, New England. Flag on this play. But Curtis Martin is in the end zone. Forget the flag if it's against Green Bay. Martin broke through the middle and got into the end zone.
It all started when they started getting some running going, and it all started when Santana Dotson and Reggie White came out. And it's going to be interesting to see what this penalty is or who it's against.
Penalty is the flag.
It's a touchdown.
Curtis Martin was really something on that. Once he hit that hole, this guy has moves on moves. He has moves in the backfield. He has moves in the hole. He has strength. And then he has moves when he gets in the open field. He said all he sees is opposite color, and he runs away from opposite color.
And right through Gilbert Brown. Those big arms didn't wrap around him.
I still don't understand why Reggie White and Santana Dotson aren't in there.
The 18-yard touchdown run, and the Patriots can move close. Lethierry's extra point is good, and it's 27-21. Here's what Bill Maz was talking about a minute ago. The vents underneath there being covered by the banners. You can see all the way around the stadium, you can see the banner material being blown, or the vents, or whatever.
I think those are the air conditioning vents. Yeah. And I think what happens is there's no air conditioning coming in here now, and all this smoke is still in here, and I think it's starting to get warmer on the field, and the players are starting to feel it.
Starting to get warmer up here.
It sure is.
Benettieri. Kick goes to Desmond Howard at the one. Desmond Howard is off. You better turn it on or he's gone. Desmond Howard all the way into the Patriot end zone. As soon as they get back in it, Green Bay takes it away. 99 yards. Longest ever in Super Bowl history. 99 yards for Desmond Howard. It had been by Fulton Walker.
You need momentum changers. You need momentum plays. You need momentum change players. And that's what Desmond Howard was right there.
He has become some weapon.
The Patriots took it away, and the Green Bay Packers took it right back.
And the Packers have to take a timeout because they didn't have the right people. They were going to go for two.
Yeah, they had about 20 guys on the field.
Yep.
Jerry Austin, the referee. That's a Super Bowl record again, in case you didn't hear. Desmond Howard. And what a factor he's been today and down the stretch for the Packers.
What a pickup he was for the Packers. Now, we talk about the job that Mike Holmgren does, but it's in conjunction with the job that Ron Wolf does. Ron Wolf gets the players, and Mike Holmgren coaches them, and and Ron Wolf has done an excellent job of getting players for this team.
Indeed he has. And they were very close to letting Desmond Howard go at the end of training camp.
Well, we did a preseason game there at the end, and I thought maybe they were going to get that. They were going to let Desmond Howard go, but Ron Wolf knew that he needed a guy that could return kicks, and he thought Desmond Howard could be one of the best, and he's proven him right.
What a weapon. You talk about most valuable players. Of course, the game is not over yet. The Packers are indeed going to go for two.
And those are the areas that you never talk about before these big games. I always talk about offense and defense and never the special teams.
Favre, all kinds of time. Shimura, get the two. 35-21. Arm had forever. Flags come flying as a scuffle breaks out in the end zone. Rarely does anybody get injured in something like this.
Aaron Taylor, number 73 for the Packers, had someone. He was holding someone down there.
The officials on the bottom.
This is that he didn't want to get in on that one. He got his hat knocked off and everyone. There's Aaron Taylor. He comes out of it. Yep. So we did it. We got that too, but that was Desmond Howard's play, though.
Yep.
The 2-point was Brett Favre to Mark Shimura. Finds him in the back of the end zone because he had plenty of time. I mean, Brett Favre
came
out there and he had great pass protection, plenty of time, and then he could go up and do this little celebration with Leroy Butler. He said they have one more part of that celebration and he forgot. But watch his kick return. First of all, you get into your wedge. That's that four group. And then you follow your next blocker. And then when you break out there and you're Desmond Howard, you just run to the end zone.
Adam Vinatieri is not going to catch you.
No, but the first thing you have to do is get it straight up into the wedge. The wedge of those four guys that are about 20 yards away from you.
And that's exactly what Desmond Howard did.
35-21 Green Bay. We're still in the third quarter. 3:10 left. You think the Patriots are coming back? You think they're getting in a position to get themselves in good shape, maybe take the lead? And here comes Desmond Howard.
Well, the Patriots did come back, and then Desmond Howard took the momentum right away from them.
Meggett fields it at about the one. Meggett is knocked backwards at about the 23 by Jeff Thomason. Super Bowl records set in this game. Four kick returns. You saw what Desmond Howard and the damage he's done. These are all the records set tonight. The most combined points set in the first quarter, the longest pass reception, most punt returns by an individual yard, 75, the longest kickoff return by Desmond Howard in both cases, 99 yards.
That's what you call a shootout.
Yeah.
You know, this isn't the 85 Bears here. This isn't dominant defense. This is shootout offenses and kick returns.
Bledsoe hit by Reggie White just as he let it go, but completes the pass to Keith Byers. Byers struggling for extra yards.
And they're still going down there. Watch Reggie White. Here he comes. Again, they try and cut him, and anytime you try and cut Reggie, and I've seen him do this for 12 years, he'll jump over it. And the one thing you learn if you're ever going to block Reggie White is you can block him different ways, but you're not going to be successful cutting him. Someone should have told Max Lane that.
12 years, never won a championship of any kind in his entire career, Reggie White. They're getting closer. Here's Bledsoe. Down he goes.
And there's Reggie White. And that's that hump move. That's the one. He learned that from Howie Long, where he gets his right arm in and just pulls the guy and hunt him right here, and he's going to come to the inside. Now watch the right arm there. See him get the right arm, and he just throws Max Lane to the side and comes right inside him. Here's the hump. You go up the field, get the right arm in, get him moving that way, and just keep his torque going that way, and then go inside him.
Maybe he heard you say he shouldn't come out for a rest.
Well, that's right. Or maybe because he was out for a rest, he was able to make moves like that.
That's possible. Reggie's coming again. And Reggie White.
Yeah. Reggie White's going to take over this game right now. That's what he's saying. There is a point. There's a point that he can't let the Patriots get the momentum back.
Wise coach Fritz Schirmer said before the game ever started that Reggie would probably have, he thought would have, the game of his life today.
Watch, here's the same thing. Now, Max Lane that time was expecting the hump move, which is an inside move, and Reggie just gave him a rip and went right under him. Here's his wife, Sarah. That's her reaction. She said, way to go, Reggie.
Desmond Howard back for Tupa's punt. And the ball goes out of bounds. That might be the wisest thing the Patriots have done all day, kick the ball out of bounds.
Yeah, there's two players that really changed things in this game. Reggie White there on defense. He just got up and says, I've never won a championship in my life. I'm this close. I'm not going to let this one get away. And before that, Desmond Howard making the big play.
The exhaust fans here in the Superdome, we understand, are in the ceiling, and those are behind the banners for fresh air coming in.
Yeah, well, that's what I was saying. Those are the vents to push the air out, but they're not pushing any air out. So there's no air in here. There's no air conditioning.
Favre to Levens, and he got a yard, maybe more, maybe not. Green Bay starting to operate from their own 37-yard line. They're leading 35-21.
And now they want to start slowing things down. So I think, you know, the 35-21, I think now you got your separation that you can go into a slowdown mode. And, of course, the Patriots are going to have to go into a fast break mode.
The Packers taking their time, down to 10 seconds left. And less than 10 on the game clock now. Here's Favre, and he's going to take off with him. He's got some room. Brett Favre slides first down midfield.
When you're Brett Favre and you're the quarterback and you're from Kill, Mississippi, You went to college in Southern Mississippi, you're going to do things like that.
Yep.
He's the darndest guy I've ever seen. He's a quarterback who plays like a nose tackle. He says, all I need is a couple of hits and I'm ready to go.
And he's got the mischief of a 7 or 8 year old in his eyes.
How about his foot? He has like 3 knuckles in his feet. They look like a hand, and he can pick up a baseball with his foot.
We saw him do it.
That is amazing.
That's the end of 3 quarters, 35-21. Bay Packer meeting on the sideline.
Well, they know, you know, when you get this close, I mean, this is what it's all about. It's not about the money. It's about being a champion. It's about getting a ring. And know that in Super Bowl 31, you will be the champion of Super Bowl 31 the rest of your life. They can never take it away from you. And when you get this close, there's no way you want it to get away from you.
First and 10, Green Bay midfield. Rising. Chase, screen pass, Levins dropped it. Bounced through his hands.
You know, he's done a real good job for the Packers today is Bruce Wilkerson, because one of the dominant defensive players of the Patriots has been Willie McGinnis. And McGinnis really hasn't done much today. I mean, he's been pretty quiet. Bruce Wilkerson has, you know, always been a right tackle all his life. He's a veteran player. He really didn't do a great job on that play, but we haven't heard McGinnis's name much today.
Just one time.
Right, and if they were going to, you know, get any pressure, it will usually come from Willie McGinnis or from the other side, Chris Slade.
Favre gets to Levin. Levin's maybe a yard. Stopped by Ted Johnson.
You know, when Bruce Wilkerson came in and started playing left tackle for the Packers, that kind of solidified that position. They started out, Gary Brown played 5 games. The rookie John Michaels played 9 games. Ken Ruckers came out and of retirement, played 1 game, went back into retirement, and then Bruce Wilkerson started 3 games. And since Bruce Wilkerson started, I think that whole line has gotten more solid.
As Mike Holmgren says, he won't give us a whiff.
He's a 10-year veteran.
Far deep. Beebe thought he was open, but nobody came close to that one. Favre just aired it out.
Yeah, we were talking about Brett Favre before, but wasn't that something where he was on the bus and he took a baseball,
yes,
and he picked a baseball up with his foot? I'd never seen anything like that. But I mean, he has like size 13 or 14 feet, and that's why he can throw passes like that and throw off his back foot.
He's not going to lose his balance. Hendrick back to punt it. High kick, Megan signals fair catch, makes it at the 20. 35-21, 14:03 left to play. And the Cheeseheads are starting to roll a little bit.
That dance was YMCA.
Yeah,
well, that's what it was. YMCA.
This is Martin. And he doesn't make it back to the line of scrimmage. Reggie White rose to the top in the last offensive series.
And these are two vintage moves. The first one is the hump, and then you expect the hump, and he gives you the rip. Now watch the rip. Just a right arm under, boom, right by both of them against Max Lane.
Reggie doesn't look like he slowed down much, does he?
Well, he didn't on that series, I'll tell you. I mean, he knew, and he can smell this now. Reggie can smell a championship, the first one in his life.
At any level. They swing it outside to Martin, and there's nothing there to make it. I beg your pardon. And there's nothing there as the Green Bay defense starting to take charge.
Yeah, again, you can tell the way things are swinging, and now they're swinging Green Bay's way on offense and defense, and they have everything they're going. And now we talk about a mode that Bill Parcells and the Patriots have to get into. They have to get in a fast break mode, and sometimes a fast break mode easily becomes a panic mode.
And that's the one thing you can't afford to do, you don't want to do. And you think you're not, but you are. Here's Bledsoe. Jefferson can't hang on. Incomplete. And the Patriots will have to punt.
And again, good defense by the Packers. You know, good coverage, good pass rush. I think that Reggie White kind of turned things over, where he got those couple sacks, and then that made everyone play a little more cautiously, get back a little more on their heels.
Desmond Howard, you mentioned his name and you associate records. Tupa trying to kick it away from him again, but he'll have a chance to operate. Desmond Howard just jogs out of bounds. This time nothing developed. 52-yard punt.
I think I've probably seen more cheeseheads this week in New Orleans than I've seen in my life.
Favre back to throw it. Gets it outside to Edgar Bennett. Second and six. Two tight ends set up for the Packers. Clock running, 11:49 left. This is Edgar Bennett. Bennett, first down, Green Bay in Patriot territory at the 46. Stopped by Chris Slade. Jim McMahon.
Yeah, he's waiting to get in the game. Jim McMahon told Brett Favre, he said, hey, when I went to the Super Bowl with the 85 Bears, he said, I was a starting quarterback, and I got my two backups. He said, not just my backup. He said, if you're the starting quarterback, he says, you have to get your backup into the game. He said, when I did it, I got both my backups into the game. So let's see what you can do.
Jim McMahon said all they want to talk to me about this week is what happened the last time I was here when I was the quarterback for the Bears. So he didn't talk all the way.
No, I know he didn't. I'd like to see Jim McMahon get in this one, too.
Bennett squirmed around, lost yardage, lost a couple.
I saw Jim McMahon before the game. I was talking to him in the field, and he comes out early and he drop kicks, and he drop kicks field goals, and he said he was going to go for a world record 60 yards. He said he had a 55 yarder and he was going to go for a 60 yarder today. Then I had to leave, so I didn't know if he made it or not.
Was that in competition or?
No, just out there. Yeah, competition. He's out here by himself, just talking to himself. This is like 3 or 4 hours before the game. What the heck's he care?
Second and 12. Packers at the Patriot 48. Here's Favre. Freeman. Incomplete.
Favre not only audibilized on that when Babbitt, you see him, he was talking to everyone. He was audibilizing and then pointing and then doing everything.
Here comes that New England package that they had trouble with earlier.
Yeah, and then they started, you know, getting some first down passing, and then that got him out of that, and then they started getting their running game going, and right now, then they have their special teams going. Right now, the Packers have everything going their way.
10-10 left to play.
I know what Mike Holmgren's feeling now. That's the longest 10-10 minutes in his whole life.
Favre to throw. Gets it up the middle. Drop by Shimura. He was open. He had the first down. He couldn't hang on. This game is presented by authority of the National Football League. It is intended for the private use of our audience. Any rebroadcast or other use of this telecast without the express written consent of the National Football League is prohibited.
Yeah, I think when Mark Shimura is your best friend and you're the quarterback and he drops one, that's why you smile, because he's your best friend. What are you going to do? You can't get mad at your best friend.
But you can, but it won't last.
Nah, you don't care about it.
Hendrick. Megan signals fair catch. Makes it at the 13. 10 Patriots at their own 14. Bledsoe. The coach quickly stays on his feet, fighting. He's hit about 5 times and hit hard. They keep him in bounds and keep the clock running, and that's what the Packers would like to do.
You see, the Patriots have to think now in terms of scoring, too. I mean, they got to get a score, then get the ball back and score again.
They go in a hurry. Newsom's back in the game, by the way, for the Packers, second and six. Bledsoe throws. It's Megan who doesn't get a first down, gets only a couple of yards, and now it brings up that big third down situation that we talked about earlier.
Yeah, and one of the guys that the Packers have controlled well today is Dave Megan. Because the Patriots were counting on him to get him a big play, and the Packers haven't let him get a big play.
Bledsoe, the coach will get the first down. coach is going to hurry back. Leroy Butler, more correctly.
There's Ray Perkins, the offensive coordinator of the Patriots, and he's not sure what's going to happen to him after this game. You know, there's a lot of uncertainty of what's going to happen to the whole coaching staff of the Patriots.
Draw play, make it, no game. Yeah, what is going to happen?
Well, I would be surprised if Bill Parcells is back. I would guess or say that this is the last game that Bill Parcells will coach for the New England Patriots. And of course his coaches will be free, and Ray Perkins isn't sure where he's going to coach.
Bledsoe going deep. It's intercepted by Newsome. And the Packers will take over.
Yeah, that's when fast break becomes panic and then you force things. And that's exactly what happened here. They knew that they needed two touchdowns. They had to get one fast. Then you throw things where you shouldn't be throwing them. Newsome knows that. He knows he's going deep. Newsome started to run deep before Sean Jefferson ever made his move. Greg Newsome read that perfectly. He was just coming off, and he started to run deep for the up pattern before Sean Jefferson even started running deep for the up pattern.
8:14 left to play. The Packers take over. You're talking about Parcells. There is, of course, the possibility that he'll sit out a year and not coach anywhere.
Yeah, that is a possibility. I mean, I would think either that or a team like the Jets, but I don't think he'll be back with the Patriots.
I agree with you. This is Edgar Bennett. No gain, stopped by Todd Collins.
There's Craig Newsome. He's saying, I knew that one. I was waiting for that one because, again, when you have them by two touchdowns, when they have to score two touchdowns, you know that they're going to take a shot at you. And they have speed like Jefferson. They're going to try and take a shot to Jefferson. So you just run where he's going to go. That's exactly what Newsome did.
Reggie White, as we mentioned previously, never won a championship way back in junior high. Before that, played all the sports at every level and never won a championship.
And Reggie White deserves a championship.
Yes, he does.
Reggie White's a good man.
That's Edgar Bennett, tripped up by Chris Slade.
You know, we talk about what the Green Bay Packers are doing now. Everything that they're in is a slowdown mode. Just run the ball, keep the ball in bounds. On the other side, they want to get the ball back, get them out of bounds. Keith Byers, of course, there played with Keith Jackson and Reggie White. They were all together at Philadelphia. I talked to Keith the other day, and he says, you know, he said, if we lose, he said, I'm going to feel real bad. I mean, it's going to hurt. But he said, I'm going to feel good for Reggie and for Keith. Keith Jackson. And I told Reggie White that, and he says, if we lose, he said, I'm not going to feel good for Keith Byers.
But you know he would.
Yeah, but this is big to Reggie. I mean, this, you know, when we talked to him the other day, you know, he was as tight and as nervous as I have ever seen Reggie White. And I've known him for 12 years.
Reggie has that raspy voice, but as somebody said, there's just a touch of sugar in that voice.
Yeah, and look, he's anxious now. I mean, with 6:45, is his wife Sarah, their family.
Yep.
They know. I mean, it's not only Reggie hasn't won a championship, they haven't won a championship. They've heard about it for a long time. And that was Reggie's yeah, but. You know, a lot of players, a lot of coaches, you have a yeah, but. He's a great player. He's a dominant player. Yeah, but he's never won a Super Bowl. I think Reggie White is going to eliminate one of his yeah, buts.
3rd and 3. Favre will throw it to Freeman, and he is hit and brought down short of a first down by Willie Clay.
Oh, there's a penalty.
Yep.
I think it was brought down. I think that's going to be a first down for the Packers.
Yes,
and that's where we talked about fast break becoming
a panic
and then becoming frustration. That's the next level. And the Patriots are going through that right now.
Personal foul, number 32 of the defense. 15. Automatic first.
Bill Parcells has made his reputation with the Giants with his great defensive unit. But to his credit, he has been able to adapt to the personnel that he was dealt.
Well, it's just the ball is the whistle's blown, and Willie Clay just knocks the ball out of his hands, And then he started to go after him. And that's what they call
foolish.
Yeah. Antonio Freeman just picked up the ball. It wasn't a first down.
No, it was not.
He knocked the ball out. I don't know that they would have called that a penalty. Then he went after him after that. Now, that was just stupid. Yeah, he's just even pointing to his head. He's even hitting himself in the head and saying that was a stupid thing to do. But again, that's when panic becomes frustration.
Packers leading 35-21, down to 2 seconds on the play clock. Here's Dorsey Levin. Levin knocked out of bounds at about the 36-yard line of New England.
I think if I had a team, in fact, when we picked the All Madden team, we took Dorsey Levins. But here's a guy who's like 6'1", 240 pounds, can run the ball, can catch the ball. You can play him in the backfield. You can split him out. You can do so many things with him that he's not a bad guy to have in your team.
No, he's not. And the Packers would like to keep him on their team. He's going to be a free agent.
Yeah, well, that's one of the things we talked about, the job that Ron Wolf has done to the general manager of this Packer team. And Ron does a pretty good job of getting the guys and then keeping the ones he has to.
Bennett straight ahead, didn't get the first down. It'll bring up a third and short. And the Patriots, I believe, have just taken a timeout with 5.5 minutes left. Flags come flying, whistles start blowing. Jerry Austin and his crew have done an outstanding job today. Yeah, they always say,
prior to the snap, ball start, number 64, 5 yards, still third down.
Wilkerson,
please reset the clock again to 5:32.
They always say that if you never notice the officials, they've done a good job.
Yeah, I think they've done a good job.
Yeah.
I can't vote for them for MVP, but here's my thing. Look, MVP right here.
I don't want to see.
I'm going to fill it out right now.
I don't want to see.
Red, Favre, Packers. That's it right there.
Red, Favre, Packers, third and seven. Favre gives to Dorsey Levins, and Levins again cuts back against the grain and cuts to about the 35-yard line, stopped by Corwin Brown. Clock continues to run. 35-21 Green Bay, Super Bowl 31.
This is one of the reasons I vote for Brett Favre for MVP. Look, he hands off, and then he goes back and he fakes that jump pass. Now, no one has thrown a jump pass since Sid Luckman.
Oh, Harry Gilmer.
Well, was Harry Gilmer after Sid Luckman?
A little bit.
But I remember Sid Luckman and Charlie Trippi. Remember, he used to get those bubble gum, and the guy would be up jumping in the air with the hand out. Right. No one's done that, and now Brett Favre is bringing that back.
Most of those guys on the cards had a ball, though.
Yeah, well, he's just playing. If he ever gets a chance to have a ball in his hand, he'll do it.
First down.
I wonder if Mike Holmgren somewhere is going to put Jim McMahon into the game.
That's George Koontz on the crutches on the sideline, who normally would have been the starting Green Bay middle linebacker. His place has been capably taken by Ron Cox.
But that was a big improvement in this Green Bay defense all this year, was George Koontz in the middle, picking up Santana Dotson from Tampa Bay, and picking up Eugene Robinson right up the middle. Those
the
three
middle.
Guys.
Favre gives to Edgar Bennett. And he nudges it over the right side. Down to about the 30. New England takes another timeout, so they only have one left. A timeout apiece left. Summarizing the game, 4 Super Bowl records set, most of them by Desmond Howard, 239 return yards, including a 99-yard kickoff return. Drew Bledsoe, 23 out of 43, three interceptions, 2 touchdowns. Favre, 2 touchdown passes, and 1 rushing TV.
I thought Drew Bledsoe played well today. I mean, you know, he did the thing. They just couldn't get any running game going. And then they got, you know, after they got that drive, then Desmond Howard broke their back with the
with the kickoff return, and they were that close. I mean, he had, you know, Drew Bledsoe's had three interceptions, but that one was kind of a, you know, type of thing, a desperation thing there at the end.
Second and seven. Favre gives to Bennett again, who nudges inside the 30, about the 29-yard line of New England. And the clock continues.
You see what Edgar Bennett's doing there, Pat, as he runs in there. He's just not going to fumble. He wasn't trying to gain a lot of yards. He's not trying to get a first down. He's not trying to get a touchdown. He was going in there and make sure that no matter what happened, he was going to hold on to that ball. And that was more important than making any moves or any big plays or anything.
Bennett and Henderson come out. So Levens will be the runner behind Favre this time.
Right now, if they don't get a first down, it'd be a 47-yard field goal attempt.
And Jacke could take it that far. Horizon incomplete. Almost. It almost hung on the hip long enough for Horizon to reach back and get it.
You know,
and we'll have Jacke.
Yeah, sometimes you can throw that thing and just throw it a little short and let him come back. And I think that's what they were trying to do. And it was right on his shoulder, and
yep.
He almost picked it off Otis Smith's shoulder.
Yep. You know, a lot of people said Rison couldn't play anymore.
Yeah, he can sure play for the Green Bay Packers. And when we talked to him the other day, we've known Andre Rison for a long time, and that was the happiest Andre Rison I ever saw.
47 yards by Jacke. It's far enough. And no good. To the right.
Well, Bill Parcells going back to work again. He just turned and said he wants four wides. So again, they have to think, the Patriots have to think here in terms of getting two scores. So you have to get one quickly. If you don't get it quickly, then you're going to have to take an onside kick.
And they only
go for an onside kick. They only have one timeout. In fact, both teams only have one timeout.
35-21. Green Bay.
But of course, if they score, that's an automatic timeout. They'll get another one at the 2-minute warning. So they do have three timeouts or so.
Packers rush just three. Bledsoe bounces one out in the direction of his wide receiver.
Yeah, this is what Fritz Schirmer's going to do now. He's going to get very conservative defensively. He's going to just rush three guys, and he's going to cover with eight, and he's going to play soft zones.
There's Bledsoe back again. This one is complete to the outside to Meggett, who gets out of bounds and stops the clock after he picked up about five or six just outside the Patriot 40. 3:46 left to play. There's Fritz Schirmer.
And again, the same thing, that three-man line, soft zone defense, and Santana Dotson gets it.
First to arrive, Reggie White right behind him.
Yeah, that should never happen. Never, ever happen. When you have five guys blocking three, they're only rushing three. Here's Santana Dotson. There's no way that he should get in there. He has a double. He goes by the center, goes by the right guard. That is terrible pass protection. That should never happen against a three-man line.
Well, you were talking earlier about what an addition Santana Dotson had been. He gets in some funny positions, but he sort of slides through people. And the Patriots punted.
Lolabaugh started on him. Ritchie went to the outside. Thompson split him.
That's Desmond Howard. Flag on the play way back in Green Bay territory. Howard almost broke another one.
If Howard would have broke one there, I would have had to get my ballot and bring it back together and scratch it out. I could still do that.
You can?
Oh yeah, you can do anything you want. I can put two or three of them in. Do I still have it?
No,
they turned it in.
It's gone.
You're in run back, holding number 37 of the receiving team, 10 yards. It'll be first down.
That's about the only way they've stopped Desmond Howard today.
Yeah, and I guess that Mike Holmgren isn't going to go for the quarterbacks and get Jim McMahon into another Super Bowl and get all his players a playing experience.
There's
Ron Wolf. We're talking about Ron Wolf, and that's Gene Washington from the league office. Remember the old 49er, ex-49er,
sure.
Just congratulating Ron
And I know Ron Wolf, he's saying, not yet. No, he's saying victory. Just wait. Hey, watch out. Yeah, Ron, no, it. Ron, not yet, not yet.
We're number one.
Yeah, I'll tell you, he deserves it. He's a great guy. Worked with Ron Wolf for 12 years with the Oakland Raiders.
He is a number one guy. And he and Mike Holmgren really work get well together. Edgar Bennett.
There's Ron Wolf there. He's just squeezing his hands, and that's going to be 2 minutes and 55 seconds. And Ron said, let's get this one over. You know, but it's been.
It looks so calm and cool.
It's been great, both of these coaches,
oh,
Pat,
sure,
and how
yeah.
cooperative they've been with us this week. And Bill Parcells, one of the great guys in this game. And like I said, I don't expect he'll be back with the Patriots. Mike Holmgren. I don't know if there's two nicer guys. I mean, good coaches, solid coaches, good guys.
I think Parcells will coach because he's a football coach, and he said that so many times. It may not be with the Patriots. In fact, I'm pretty sure it's not going to be with the Patriots.
Yeah, I don't think it'll be with the Patriots. In fact, he's not even flying home with the team.
Right? I knew that.
Yeah, he has another flight going somewhere else. So.
Well, that's 33-14 for Green Bay. That was Super Bowl number two. You were an assistant coach for the Raiders.
Yep. Vince Lombardi was the coach of those Green Bay Packers.
That's his last game.
That was his last game as a coach of the Packers.
Zamora goes in motion. Favre looking to throw. Gets away from McGinnis, but not from Bruschi.
You know, it was funny when we talked to Mike Holmgren the other day. He said one thing he didn't want Brett Favre to do is run backwards. He said if he got in trouble, he always wanted him to run forward, step forward. But when he gets in trouble and runs backwards, he said all he does is get in more trouble. At least he didn't do it until the last 2 minutes of the game.
2 minutes. Bay leading 35-21. Craig Hendrick back to punt to Dave Meggett. Brett Favre, your choice for most valuable player, and that's not a bad one.
He just, you know, he's more than a quarterback. Brett Favre is a football player that I think could just play anywhere.
He could. And does. Megan. Packer coverage is good, and down there first is Travis Jervey. Green Bay tradition, the Packers in Lambeau Field, and Vince Lombardi, the trophy named after him. Now to Mike Holmgren. And the names in the history, Bart Starr, Brett Favre, the new dynasty, Ray Nitschke, Reggie White.
Kind of the new taking over for the old, but I think really they're all going to join. It's going to just be one Packer legacy.
And Reggie again. His third sack of the day.
Max Lane has sure got an education from Reggie White today. Especially at the end of this game, Reggie took him to school.
It's hard to believe in a guy as big as Reggie is. 6'5 and 300 or whatever he weighs.
That's that hump move again.
Yep. Can be so gentle. Incomplete intended for Megan.
You know that move, he learned it from Howie Long, like I said earlier, and Howie called it a hump move and Reggie White called it a Howie. But I tell you, he came on when there was a game to be won. Reggie said there's a game to be won. I don't know how much gas I have left in this tank. But whatever it is, I'm going to empty it out.
A lot.
And he emptied it today.
A minute 27. Patriots out of timeouts. Packers up by 14. Bledsoe is hit just as he let it go. Complete to Brisby, who is hit by Newsome.
Poor old Max Lane, he's going to be thinking about Reggie White. Max Lane's only in his third year. He's going to be a good one. He's from Navy, but Reggie White took him to school today.
Three sacks, seven hurries, seven hits. Here's Bledsoe. He's caught by Brisby. It bounces to the Packers. To Brian Williams, and Williams still on his feet, still struggling. And the Packers have the ball at the New England 21-yard line. The Packers are going to enjoy the fruit and the Lombardi Trophy.
And that was Craig Newsome's hit. Boy, did Newsome hit Prisby. Williams ends up with the interception. And when we look at it again, we're going to see Craig Newsome, number 21, come up and really make a hit. Watch him. Here's Craig Newsome here, and he's going to unload on Prisby. He's going to knock the ball out. Watch as it comes up here. Now he reacts, and he sees it. Now watch right there. Boom! He just hit him and knocked everything out of Prisby.
Even made me say boom.
That's one of the first booms of your life.
Yeah.
But that was Craig Newsome. Williams gets the interception, but it was really Craig Newsome's.
50 seconds left to play. And those who say these games are boring, play a tape of this one.
Yeah, or be part of the Green Bay Packer team. Be a Green Bay Packer coach. Be Mike Holmgren. Be Reggie White. Yeah. Be Brett Favre.
Favre kneels down the clock.
Be Bruce Wilkerson.
They start shaking hands. Mike Holmgren. Officially, we've just been notified the most valuable player of the game is Desmond Howard.
Well, you were right. That's what you said you should have voted for, or I should have voted for.
You vote for who you want to.
No. He was, you know, he changed things around. I think they all did a great job. I think Desmond Howard did, and he's an MVP, and he deserves it. You know who I voted for?
Yep. From a guy who was almost cut in training camp, the first special team player ever to win the Super Bowl MVP title.
And this is what it's all about. Winning a championship.
Couldn't happen to a nicer guy.
The greatest moment of your life. You'll never forget it. They could never take it away.
Brett Favre's dad. He has to be swelling up proud. The final score here at Super Bowl 31 is the Green Bay Packers 35, the New England Patriots 21.